The number one requested feature for VAPI AI is a custom knowledge base. And this is exactly what this tutorial will be about. You will learn step by step how to integrate your own knowledge base so that your voice agent is able to answer any questions about your company or any other information that's included in the knowledge base. I made this tutorial mainly because VAPI AI currently doesn't have any native solutions for that. But if you're watching this at a later time, you might still find this tutorial helpful if you're experiencing any issues with the knowledge base, because I'm gonna explain everything as simple as possible. All this will be done using no-code tools, so it's easy for anybody to replicate. All the tools I'm using are either free or pretty cheap to use, and the method I'm using, I believe, is best for retrieving accurate information. As always, you can access all my templates for free in the link in the description below. In my free Discord community, you'll find many people who implement my templates into real businesses. Feel free to connect with others and please ask for help if you're stuck with anything. Now, let me explain the tools you need and how the system actually works. First, we have our voice agent in VAPI, which will be equipped with a prompt and a function to retrieve the knowledge base. Next, we'll need Flowwise. Flowwise is a free no-code tool that's used to create agents and chatbots, but in our case we'll use it to create a RAG system. The name Retrieval Augmented Generation sounds more complicated than it actually is. RAG is a technique used to accurately and reliably retrieve information from an external data source. We'll use make.com to enable the communication between Flowwise and VAPI. Furthermore, we need Rendered to host Flowwise on. You could also just have Flowwise installed locally on your computer for free, but this would come with some disadvantages, such as not being able to access Flowwise from anywhere or needing to have your computer turned on 24/7. In this tutorial, I will show you how to install Flowwise on Render. But you can also find a link in the description below leading to a tutorial that shows how to install Flowwise locally. The RAG in Flowwise will send your data over to OpenAI to turn your information into vectors. A vector is just a numerical representation of your data. For example, the vector for the word elephant could look something like this. And this vector needs to be stored in a vector database, and we'll use Pinecone for that. Now you might be wondering, why do we even turn our data into numbers? Well, that's because with numbers, the models can do a bunch of calculations that allow us, for example, to determine how similar or how relevant the information is. Now, let's first create our voice assistant in VAPI. I'll call this assistant Leo, and he will be able to answer any questions about Harmony Estate Management, which is a property management company that I made up. This prompt is available in my resources. We also need a function, let's call it knowledge base, with the property question. The next step is to install Flowwise on Render. Create an account. Click on New and Web Service. And now you'll need to connect your GitHub account to Render. But before that, we need to make sure that we fork Flowwise on GitHub. For that, go to GitHub and search for Flowwise and click on Fork. Then you can go back to Render, connect your GitHub account, and create a repository for Flowwise. Click Connect. Choose your region here. When it comes to the selection of a plan, you can choose the free one, but you should be aware that the free plan doesn't include persistent storage, which means that your data could get lost any moment the server is disconnected. So if you want to use Flowwise just for testing purposes, then use the free plan, and if you want to use it for production, use the starter plan. Next, we need to create some environment variables such as username and password that you will use later to log in into Flowwise. Just copy paste everything from my resources. If you are on a free plan, you can now click on create web service. But if you are on a paid plan, we need to add a disk and some more variables. Click on create web service and you will see the installation of Flowise. This process will take a couple of minutes, and when it's done, you will see a screen like this. And now you can access Flowise through this link. Once logged in, click on add new to create a new workflow. Now import the template that I provided in my Discord server. This is the REC workflow, and we'll go over the modules one by one. The first one is the OpenAI module, where you need to grab your API keys and create your credentials. The next module is Pinecone, our vector database, where our data will be uploaded to in the form of vectors. I really recommend Pinecone as a vector database because it has a pretty extensive coverage of services in the free plan, which is enough for most of small projects. Now let's create an index. This is where your vectors will be stored in. You can name it whatever you want. Mine will be called Harmony Essay. For the dimensions, type in 1536, create an index and copy your API keys and paste it into Pinecone. The index name should be the same as in Pinecone. The next module is the embeddings module, where your data will be turned into vectors. Select your OpenAI credentials. My next module is an Airtable module because that's where my data is. But you could replace this module if you have another type of data. Now we need to get our API keys from Airtable. For that, go to Developer Hub. By the way, this table will be included in my resources, so you can use it for testing purposes. Go to Personal Access Tokens and create a new token. Add all the scopes. And copy your token and paste it into Flowise. In the last step, we need to copy and paste the details of the URL into the respective boxes in Flowise. If you have reached this part, congratulations, you are almost done. Save your workflow. Click on the green button. By doing this, your data on Airtable will first be turned into vectors and then uploaded to Pinecone. You can see your upsert was successful when this number is not a zero anymore. You can also test if your REC is working properly by asking a question that could be answered based on your Airtable information. And here you can even see where this information is coming from. In our final step, we need to enable the communication between Flowise and WAPI. The template for this make scenario is included in my resources. Upload it into Make, copy the webhook address, and paste the webhook address into the function in WAPI. In the next module, we're making an HTTP request to Flowise. Copy this URL in Flowise and paste it into this box. And this is how the rest of the module should look like. Finally, in the last module, we're sending the answer that we got from Flowise back to WAPI. Now let's test the workflow. Go back to WAPI and go to your knowledge base function. We can type in the same question as before. And now we can see the output here. This is the answer that we got from the Airtable. Now let's talk to Leo from Harmony Estate Management.
How do you make sure your properties are leased quickly? One moment. We employ comprehensive marketing strategies and conduct thorough tenant screenings to lease properties swiftly. Our goal is to minimize vacancy periods and ensure that properties are leased to qualified tenants in a timely manner. If you have any more questions, feel free to ask.
Okay, how long have you been in business?
One moment. Harmony Estate Management has been in business for over 10 years, serving our community with dedication. If you have any more questions or need further assistance, feel free to ask.
What happens when appliances break?
Give me a moment. Maintenance issues, including broken appliances, are handled by our qualified maintenance team. Tenants can report any issues to our office and we will promptly address them.
If you're interested in creating an AI voice agent that is able to book appointments, then watch this tutorial and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any updates.